Welcome to another video and episode on my robotic arm with pneumatic hand, which is controlled by the Fisiotechnic rubber interface with extension connected to a computer on which Python runs, so it's not that the program actually runs here. Pneumatic compression chamber, pneumatic engine, my design, and wired to pivot engine for the arm base, pivot motor actually, and bipolar switch, pneumatic hand with robotic wrist, and also bipolar switch for letting the hand move, and also switch here that is for switching between this motor for the roll and motor on the other side for the yaw movement. That has to be improved yet, but that comes later. Recently I improved the stability and robustness of the elbow, and I came to the conclusion that something else has to be improved as well after I improved the position and stability of this particular construction, which is to actually keep touching this switch back and forth, back and forth. Another problem is that I have two motors left which are not exactly stable. This one shows continuous problem with the wiring, and so does the yaw motor. And this motor already is completely wired, well, let's say nicely attached, but still able to disconnect. This one still isn't. So my first focus is now to use these parts to change that. So let's say this one is going here with these parts connecting in here, and two of these wires will then connect to the motor being soldered to the motor, fixed. Same with the other one. And then hoping that all wiring issues are over, and more so that the not so good connection to the yaw motor, which is very experimental, very fragile, very easily disconnected, and that will change as well. So let me take out first this motor and do it, or bring the equipment here and do that. But first I have to prepare something. Strip a wire end, connect connectors, and then put in here. So let's see how that ends up. Alright, first steps. Take the wires off of here and put them in the connector, and have the connector put here for a moment. I strip the wires and put two connectors on them. Two connectors less, because I only need these ones and these ones, and these were already on there. So this is the right sequence. So this red one will go here, the green one will go here, and hopefully it will be the same one as, or as easy as this one has been, but you never know. One look is not guaranteed, but not guaranteeing the other one. Also, I have to keep in mind that these wires are sticking out, so I probably want to route them through here and then have the connector somewhere located here. We'll see. So that's solder. All right, so with a strip tool here, wire strip tool, and solder equipment, I have now soldered these wires to the motor. This one is to be connected, but this is old situation, of course, and I much better put it like that. So what I intend to do instead is rewire a bit, taking this one out and then noticing that the wire here goes out, which is not intention. So with a screwdriver I have to reattach, and I know that the sequence of the wires will be inverse to that one, so that's not much a problem. This one goes in here, or should be anyway. No, I have to widen the gap. And these wires are rather weak, so I have to be careful. That is better. So yes, rewiring is the thing. Let me put this one here. So red goes below, green goes up. That's the way to do it. Then this one, right, that's a little bit weird. Then do I have to use this? Maybe not. Let's first connect this one here, this one in here, this is best I think, and I may have to use it anyway to wire up this nice and properly. So now I can take these out because I know where they have to be. And yes, it is way too long, but for now it will have to do. And these go there, so a little bit of putting them away. Never goes as easy as you like with limited capacity. So let me put it right here for now. And the wiring goes here. And yeah, I will have to redo the wiring, but that's the idea. Now the big question is, does it work? So without running the program, I have the diagnostics. So let's run that one. Open the diagnostics interface, And of course, which wire is it? It's number 2 on the slave. No problem there. And no problem there. So that runs nicely. Which brings an end to the first wiring operation. I'll have to tidy this up later. Second one is the yaw motor, which is on the other side. So let's go there. Right, and then the second motor, the yaw motor, right here. And they can be right now disconnected quite easily. So you can imagine that this kind of wiring is not the best. So in comes this one, which easily connects in here. And for this one, I'll have to be certain that I know which one goes where. So I will put it right here and put the wires subsequently. But then I'll have to remember that red goes here. So nice and tidy. Let's go for it. All right, so I first soldered the wires in order to know which wire goes where. Now it should be simply a matter of wiring it up. And red and green. Ah, and here I still have the wire in. So not anymore. And then how goes it? Well, this is not a smart idea because of the rotation of the arm. So let's just keep it like this. That's a better idea. So this is how things should be, and it is the same way as this, just being connected nicely. And remember, on the other side the roll motor is also hanging loose, so that is no problem, or should be no problem. As long as this stays in, otherwise the wire might be too long. Anyway, this is a nice solution. Soldering done. Now for some testing. Right, with everything fixed, let's run the algorithm and see how things properly work or not. And starting it. And pitch works. And the pivot works down here very well, even. And this was already working, I see on the screen. So that is very nice. Now let me try the arm, or the hand more appropriately. Yes, that is finger 2, finger 3, finger 4, and the thumb is working, but finger 1 I have missed. Yes, finger 1 also. And This has also worked twice by now, three times now. So that's all good. And here the pivot below works. Although somehow this engine slows down a bit. I'm not sure why. It slows down, speeds up, slows down, speeds up. But right now I'm glad that this is properly working, this construction. The motor is nicely working, and you can see that I tied up the wires. And this has worked again. Yep, and that was a slowing down of the engine, very much so. It seemed to have to do with the wiring to the motor, but I'm not quite sure. So, this is all nicely working now. Let's have a visual of, hopefully, of the yaw motor working. Yes, I see it work now. So that is very good. So, everything seems to work. And I didn't show the hand properly, so let's do one finger, yes, and another one. Getting out of screen, out of view, but it doesn't matter. It works. So it seems that it finally does work. And let's also view the output on the screen, because without that you never know. So I started from review, and as you can see, noticed I did not interview time. So okay, that works. Thing for twice, and here is the version 1. Then the other time direction 0 and 1, and we get 1 and 0. That's 3 times, 4 times 0 and 1, and 1. Yeah, I'm getting quite that it has worked. Now, notice that one, of course, is that the X work as should. Because the chain is slipping. Because of the one bipolar switch and non-bipolar switch with some activation, it eventually does work. And it's two mode soldering, one
that is, I think, actually the best thing, because it was wired before, absolutely dramatic. Could easily be also happen to be connected, and then wondering why. The only thing that is the wiring of the amp, but that would require build and redesign. Waiting for that. That's not what to do. As you can see, everything has worked. Compressor motor. The yaw. So, let's just run it. Let's see if this has been a coincidence. Now goes, yes, if it works actually, yes, and of course need with the time. This is unfortunately not you also see digital 11 being and only when 11 is 1 it works now. So now I'm waiting for this reverse happening. That's very good. And working again when the has grip on the because that all digital being by power switch is going way more than will ever will be. That's how it is working. Not bad.
And it's time for a wrap right now. So, as demonstrated, things do work, and I, of course, I'm convinced things can be improved. So I will keep looking for that. But for now, thanks for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel, give the video a thumbs up, and leave a comment or suggestion. What more can be done, or what more should be done? You can also follow me on Instagram and Twitter. Please support my blog and videos by making a donation via PayPal and Wired or Wired. You can also become a patron and have your name mentioned with my videos. All information via under my video, as well as URL of my website with much more information, details on how to donate via Wired, and pictures, lots of pictures, on events that I have visited with all kinds of models. Once again, thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Probably to be continued. Bye bye.